Hello everyone, welcome to this session on unit load method. And in this problem we are going to solve how to find out the deflection. And this is a particular beam. For the beam shown in figure, determine the deflection at the free end of the overhang beam. So this is an overhanging beam wherein there are three points which have been named. Three points are A, B and C, and amongst these three points, A is provided with a support and B is also provided with a support, and C doesn't have any support, so no support is been provided at point C, so which indicates C is a free end, so which means we are going to find out deflection at point C. So this will be an overhang beam ABC, and support is been provided at A and B, and C is a free end, and for that reason we will be finding out deflection at the free end, which is delta C. That is, free end means it is deflection at point C. To begin with the solution, first and the foremost thing is to find out the reaction. Now when we find out the reaction, this particular method, this particular problem will be solved by unit load method. So when we solve by unit load method, so reaction will be calculated for two cases. First case is for the external load, reaction due to the external load, and then the reaction due to the unit load. So what it indicates is we are going to impose a unit load or unit concentrated force at the position where deflection needs to be evaluated. Now as we are going to find out deflection at the free end, that is at point C, we are going to impose a unit load at point C, that is at this particular position at point C, we are going to impose a concentrated load. So when we impose a concentrated load at point C, it is quite clear that we will be finding out deflection at point C. It is very much essential to have a concentrated force at the position where we want to compute the deflection. So this particular problem can be reframed and then reimposed as by principle of superposition as the original statement of the problem plus the beam as it is, and then imposition of 1 kilonewton load at the free end. This 1 kilonewton load at the free end has been imposed just to find out the deflection at point C. Distance remains same, that is distance between B and C is 2 meter, distance between A and B is 6 meter, likewise distance between A and B is 6 meter, and distance between B and C will be 2 meter. We are not going to change any statement of the problem. Statement of the problem, diagram, everything will remain same. Only modification that we are going to do is wherever we want to find out the deflection at that particular position, we are going to impose a 1 kilonewton concentrated force. Once we have done with this, now first and foremost task is to find out the reaction. To find out the reaction, we'll find out the reaction for both the cases. Now, first reaction due to external load, that is first reaction due to external load. Next reaction is due to the unit load. Whatever the moment we are going to calculate due to the external load, that moment we shall call it as capital M. Likewise, whatever moment we are going to calculate due to 1 kilonewton load, that moment we call it as small m1. Now how to find out the reaction is apply the equations of equilibrium. To apply the equations of equilibrium, take summation Fi is equal to 0. Va plus Vb, as both the forces are upward, plus Va plus Vb, minus 45 into total distance of the length of the load, length of UDL will be 6 plus 2, it will be 8 meter, which is equal to 0. So Va plus Vb is equal to 45 is the magnitude of UDL and total length of UDL is 8 meter, so that's why 6 plus 2 will be 8 meter. So total magnitude will be 45 into 8, which shall come as 360 kilonewton. So 360. Name this as equation number 1, 45 into 8 will come as 360. After this, we need to find out the reaction. To find out the reaction, take moment with respect to A is equal to 0. If we take moment with respect to A is equal to 0, minus Vb into 6. When I consider moment with respect to A is equal to 0, distance between A and B is 6 meter. And direction of rotation of Vb will be in the upward direction, to rotate in anti-clockwise direction. So minus. So Vb into 6. Plus of 45 into 8 into 8 divided by 2, that is equal to 0. 45 into 8 means total magnitude of the load. 8 divided by 2 means it is a centroid or the CG of the load. Total length of the load is this 8 meter and centroid will be 8 divided by 2, that is equal to 0. So VB into 6 is equal to, if you check out 2 ones are 2 fours are. So it will come as 45 into 8 into 4, which is 1140, which will be VB is equal to 1440 divided by 6. So same value we are going to divide it by 6, wherein VB value shall come as 240 kilonewton. So solution is not yet over. VB value we have calculated. Next task is to find out the value of VA. To find out the value of VA, it will be 360 minus of 240, which will be VA is equal to minus of 360 minus of 240, wherein it will come as 120 kilonewton. So VA value will be 120 kilonewton. So this is what is the value of VB and VA that will be helpful to find out further moment equation. So VA value is 120. VA value is 120. VB value will be 240. So this is nothing but the computation of the reaction component due to the external load. This is over now. Next is to find out the computation of the reaction component due to 1 kilonewton load. Now to find out that, you shall take summation Fi is equal to 0 again. VA plus VB minus of 1 is equal to 0 because it is in the downward direction. Why we are imposing in the downward direction? Because UDL is in the downward direction. And as per Newton's laws of motion, whichever direction the force is impressed along that particular direction, object or the body tends to move. As the load is in the downward direction, the object moves in the downward direction. So assuming and presuming that the load will move in the downward direction, so you are going to apply the force in the downward direction. So that's why it is minus of 1. So VA plus VB is equal to 1. This is equation number 2. Then similar procedure, we are going to find out moment with respect to A. When I find out moment with respect to A, with reference to A, reaction component at B will rotate in anti-clockwise direction. So minus VB into 6 plus of 1 into 8, that is equal to 0. That is, distance between A and B is 6 meter. Distance between A and 1 kilonewton load is 8 meter. So 1 into 8 is equal to 0. So VB is equal to 8 divided by 6. That is, when you take it on the right hand side, VB into 6, this will come in the denominator. So 8 divided by 6. So 8 divided by 6, when you do, it will come as 1.33. So VB value is 1.33 kilonewton. Now what will be the value of VA? Again, bring back this particular equation here. When you bring back that particular equation, VA will be equals to 1 minus of VB. That is 1 minus of 1.33. So what will be the value of VA now? So which is 1 minus of 1.33, which indicates minus 0.33. So minus indicates the reaction has to be in the downward direction. Instead of upward, it has to be in the downward direction, which is 0.33. And this is 1.33. Minus indicates the direction has to be in the reverse order. While considering the equation, we had considered it as positive, assuming it will be in the upward direction. After calculation, we got the reaction to be negative, which means the reaction has to be reversed. So it has to be oriented in the downward direction. So this will be the reaction component which will be helpful to find out the value of M1. Whereas the reaction component calculated due to the external load will help us to find out the value of M. So that is what we have calculated. Reaction component due to external load, reaction component due to the unit load. So when we frame a table here, so table should have all the comprises. So when we frame a table, table will be represented like this. Serial number, span, limits, and origin, EI value, capital M, and small m1. Capital M means it is a moment due to external load, that is, external load means UDL. Small m1 means it is moment due to unit load. Unit load means a load of magnitude 1 kilonewton. Now when I start with a span here, I shall redraw this particular diagram again for better understanding, so that solution will be much more easier. So diagram what we had is, first diagram was a UDL and it had two reaction component, and the reaction component what we had was 120 and 240. So we'll write it here, 120 and 240. Distance between both this is 6 meter and here it is 2 meter. Magnitude of UDL is 45 kilonewton per meter. Magnitude of UDL, which has been given in the statement of the problem as 45 kilonewton per meter. Same thing on the right hand side, we had one more diagram wherein reaction was in the downward direction here, which is 0.33. If you show it upward, you need to write it as minus 0.33. Then this value was 1.33 and unit load has been placed here, which is at a distance of 2 meter, and this is placed at a distance of 6 meter. Point A, point B and point C. Point A, point B and point C. So these are nothing but the forces that will help us. Whatever moment we are going to calculate due to this part, which will be called as capital M. Whatever moment we are going to calculate due to this part will be called as small m. So first part I shall start from point A and then proceed towards point B. Then I shall write it here, span AB. And distance between AB is 6 meter. So limits will be 0 to 6. And origin will be A. EI value, if we happen to cross verify, EI value which has been given here is 2. So EI value shall write it as 2. Now I shall write the value of M here. When I write the value of M here, section shall start from A and it will terminate at B. So at any distance X here, what will happen? Moment at X will be 120 into X, because at any position X here, 120 is upward, which will rotate in clockwise direction, 120 into X. Then on top you have a UDL, which will rotate in anti-clockwise direction. So minus of 45 into X divided by 2. Reframing this equation, this will be 120 into X minus 45 X square by 2. Or else it can also be written as 120 X minus of 45 divided by 2 shall come as 22.5. That is 45 divided by 2 shall come as 22.5. So this will be minus 22.5 times of X square. This is the moment calculation for the span A to B. Likewise, you will need to also calculate the moment calculation for the span A to B here also. That is for M1. When I calculate here, with reference to this point, again, same condition. Section shall start from A, it will be at any distance X here. Where at any distance X, what will be the condition? 0.33 is downward, so it will rotate in anti-clockwise direction. So moment at any distance X will be minus 0.33 or 33 times of X. Minus because it rotates in anti-clockwise direction, so minus 33 times of X. This particular value is for the span A to B again, and that particular value shall be written in the column called as M1. So same thing we are going to rewrite here. This will be 120x minus 22.5 times of x square. Then here it will be minus 0.33 times of x. This is the first condition, that is from the span A to B. That means we have traversed from the part A to B. continuing further, we are moving to move from B to C. So which is B to C. When I move from B to C, at A it is 0. At A coordinate is 0. At B it is 6. At C it will be, if I start from origin A means X will be 0. Origin B means X will be 6. Origin A means at C, X will be 8 meter. So when I mention B to C, limits will be mentioned as 6 to 8. Limits will be mentioned as 6 to 8. Because at B, X coordinate is 6, at C, X coordinate is 8. And origin will be again A, and EI value for the span AB to C, for the span B to C it is 1. So we are going to write it as 1. Now next term is to write the value of capital M and small m. To write the term for capital M and small m1, here it is B to C. So again section shall start from A because origin is A. So section shall start from A. So when I write the value of mx here, then rewrite this particular diagram, then write the value of mx. So this will be a diagram, and section will reach here now. When section reaches here, total distance will be x here. And this is VA value, whose value is 120, and VB value, whose value is 240. If I write down the moment equation here, this is already 45. If I write down the moment equation here, which will be 120 into x minus of 45 into x divided by 2, then plus of 240. 240 with reference to a given section, it has been placed here. I need to find out this particular distance between 240 and the given section. 240 and the given section, that particular distance will be, total distance is x and this distance is 6, and the left out distance will be x minus of 6, which indicates it will be 240 into x minus of 6. So this is the value of the moment that we are going to consider. Reframing this is 45 divided by 2 will be 22.5, which has already been calculated here. So 120 into x minus 22.5 x square plus 240 into x minus of 6, which is moment at x now. So this will be the value of mx that we are going to write it and fill in this particular bracket now, this particular box. So which will be 120x minus of 22.5 x square plus of 240 into x minus of 6, which is nothing but the value of VB. This is the value of VA. This is the value of UDA. Once we have done with this, same thing is we need to fill up this particular M1 bracket. To fill up this particular M1 bracket, we are going to refer this particular equation. Then if I redraw this particular diagram, the diagram will be considered in this fashion. Now instead of considering the section here, we are going to consider the section at the far away location here. And what will be the equation here? Mx equation will be minus of 0.33 times of x plus of distance between the given section here will be x minus of 6 plus of 1.33 times of x minus of 6. This will be an expression that we are going to substitute here, which will be minus of 0.33 times of x plus of 1.33 x minus of 6. So this will be the value of M and M1. Now, most important task is to substitute in the integration term. To substitute in the integration term, delta at C will be, integration capital M small m1 dx divided by EI, which will be 0, that is 0 to 6 first term, 0 to 6 small m, capital M for the first term will be 120 x minus 22.5 x square, that is capital M. Small m1 will be minus 0.33 times of x dx divided by 2 EI. This is capital M. This value what I have written is capital M. This is small m1, which is as per the given table here. Okay. This we shall keep it for the span A to B. Next is for the span B to C. When I write it for the span B to C, it is 6 to 8. Then value of capital M here is 120 into x minus of 22.5 x square plus of 240 into x minus of 6, 240 into x minus of 6, in bracket minus of 0.33, that is the second term, minus of 0.33 times of x plus of 1.33 x minus of 6 dx divided by EI. Now only thing is we need to substitute in the calculator and then check out what will be the integration value. If I check out the first value, this now. Start with an integration term, don't put any values here. Type as it is along with a bracket. So I shall open with a bracket here. Reason for not typing in the first bracket here is because it is left for the limits to be substituted. So for that I shall open with the first bracket. 120x, 120 alpha x minus of 22.5 alpha x square, close the bracket because it closes with the bracket, in bracket minus of 0.33 alpha x, close the bracket, comma, 0, 6. Now close the bracket. This will lead to a solution as -445 here, -445.5 divided by 2. Why divided by 2? Because it is dx divided by 2, so that will come here divided by 2 ei. So keep this as it is. Then check out the second term. This is for the span a to b, ab. Now move for the next term again. So again I repeat, type it as it is. Don't substitute in this particular term because it is left for the limits. Open one more bracket. 120 alpha x minus of 22.5 alpha x square plus 240 in bracket alpha x minus of 6, close the bracket. Open with one more bracket here. Minus of 0.33 alpha x plus 1.33 in bracket alpha x minus 6, close the bracket, comma 6, 8. So which will come as 88.8. Check out here, 88.8 divided by ei. So if you happen to check out here, it has been typed as it is in the equation. 120x minus of 25x square minus of 25x square plus 240 in bracket x minus of 6, close the bracket. That is this particular part. Then open with one more bracket, that is the second term, which is m1. Minus of 0.33 times of x plus of 1.33 x minus of 6, close the bracket, comma 6, 8, which is nothing but integration limit, and you will be getting the value as 88.8 divided by ei. Now simplifying further here, 445.5 divided by 2 minus of 445.5 divided by 2, which will be minus of 222.75 minus of 222.75 divided by ei here. 222.75 divided by ei plus of 88.8 divided by ei. For the same value, we are going to add plus 88.8, and net value shall come as 133.95, which is minus of 133.95 divided by ei. 133.95 minus indicates we had assumed to be in the downward direction, deflection to be in the downward direction. Minus indicates it is reverse order, the deflection has to be in the upward direction. That is, it will be in the upward direction. Why it will be in the upward direction is, as the UDL magnitude is more, it will move downward and then proceed it in the upward direction. So this is what is delta C. So this is how we are supposed to find out deflection at point C whenever it is an overhang beam. So first and foremost task is to find out reaction component. After the calculation of the reaction component, we need to frame a table mentioning span, ei, capital M and small m. Capital M means it is a moment caused due to the external load. Small m1 means it is a moment caused due to the unit load. The moment calculation has been considered with reference to a common origin point. And whenever we refer to a common origin point, at common origin point, at A it is 0, at B it will be 6, at C it will be 8, because total distance between A and C will be 6 plus 2, it will be 8. For that reason, at B it is 6, at C it will be 8, so limits will be considered as 6 to 8. Likewise, at A it is 0, at B it is 6, so limits will be 0 to 6. And these are the given values in the diagram, so for this we do not have to think much. Here everywhere all clockwise direction rotation to be positive and all anticlockwise direction to be negative. So by this fashion we are supposed to calculate the value of capital M, small m1, capital M and small m. This is for the span B to C. This is for the span A to B. After this we are going to integrate this and consider same as it is in the calculator to calculate. So this is the value of AB. Divided by 2 is considered here because it is dx divided by 2 ei. And here it is dx divided by 1 ei, for that reason the denominator is considered as 1 ei. This is for the span B to C. After calculation, this you are going to get it as negative. Negative means actually you are considering the force to be downward, it has to be in the upward direction. If you reverse the force and put it in the upward direction, that means the beam will move in the upward direction. So this is how the beam will move in the upward direction. Why this happens to move in the upward direction here is because within the center span, udial magnitude is more. So this will move downward and this will move in the upward direction. So this is how we are supposed to calculate deflection by unit load method for a overhanging beam. Thank you. Have a nice day.